In your next event, Buffalo Billiards, get your game on. Speaking of getting your game on, we have a good one tonight here at the Austin Convention Center as the Toros get it first to begin the fourth period. Up by two, 71-69. Curtis Gerald splits two defenders, kicks left. Carter from the baseline, shot won't go. And the rebound taken by Tulsa's Cecil Brown.
Nice penetrating kick by Curtis Gerald, setting up Russell Clark for the open jumper. Just wasn't able to knock it down.
Yemi Agunye nearly stripped by Alonzo G, who's playing tough defense out near midcourt. Shot clock at eight. Yemi picks up his dribble, gives to Keith Clark. Step back up top, over to Agunye. Penetrates, two to shoot, stolen by the Toros. And here they come up the center of the floor. Squeaky to Alonzo G. Stop and pop, long two is no good. And the rebound to Yemi Agunye. And Coach Nate Tibbetts tells everyone to hold on, let's slow it up, walk it across, and look for a good shot. The five out there for the Toros. Dwayne Jones. Well, more on that in a moment. Let's get to the Tulsa play first. Harden spinning in the lane. Shot is good, and he's fouled. A chance to take the lead with a free throw.
Yeah, Devon Harden with a great move in the paint. Was able to drive one way and get Dwayne Jones leaning that way. As a replay, the Lone Star Network replay shows, and he spun back into the middle of the lane. Able to finish the shot, going to the foul line for three. Possible three the hard way.
Free throw is good for Harden. So Harden has nine in the game, and Tulsa in front for the first time since, I believe, the opening quarter. So it's Squeaky Johnson, Alonzo G, Dwayne Jones, Curtis Gerald, and Russell Carter. Here's Squeaky, dribbles to the foul line, over to Gerald's right wing. Gerald's couple of dribbles to his right, up top Squeaky, thought about the three, didn't take it. As Johnson defending him in the man-to-man, Squeaky penetrates, steps back, fades, and the rebound taken by Harden on the air ball by Squeaky Johnson. Tulsa, a one-point lead and the ball. Mitch Johnson penetrates down the lane, puts it up, no good. Follow dunk attempt, no good for Harden, and the Toros race out. It's Curtis Gerald's down the lane, flips it up, air ball. Alonzo G has it, saves it over to Carter, and now the Toros will wisely hold it up. A little bit out of control the first 2 minutes of the fourth quarter. Gerald's thought about the three. Foul line extended right, instead penetrates to Squeaky. He'll shoot the three, got it! Squeaky Johnson drains the three, and the Toros go in front by two, 74-72.
Coach Snyder going again with that two-point guard look here in the fourth quarter. Paying dividends there, Squeaky Johnson knocks down the three-point shot.
Mitch Johnson, the guard out of Jarvis Christian, pounding out the left-handed dribble against Squeaky in the man-to-man. Off the screen, it's Brown. His jumper in and out, and the rebound taken by the Toros' Dwayne Jones. Curtis Gerald runs it up again. Passes right to the cutting. Carter goes reverse side and scores. Russell Carter lays it in. His second field goal of the game, and the Toros back in front by four.
It's that offensive transition we were talking about earlier. Good defense by the Toros. Allowed them to get out on the break with Russell Carter finishing for two.
Johnson between his legs on the dribble against Squeaky Johnson. Tulsa's got it in the front court. Keith Clark at the three-point line against the shorter Squeaky. Drives against him, blocked by Dwayne Jones. He nearly knocked that one into the men's restroom.
Yeah, he almost took a fan out on the baseline seats there. Great help on the weak side. Great recognition by Dwayne Jones coming across, helping Squeaky Johnson on the drive there with the big block baseline side.
Well, Keith Clark, his eyes lit up when he saw the shorter Squeaky Johnson on him. Agunye, Mitch Johnson, and Harden to the bench. Inbounds pass. Mullen shoots a tough shot with the shot clock winding down, and that is a shot clock violation on the Tulsa 66ers. Turnover number 15. So the 66ers with a lineup of Keith Clark, Larry Owens, Byron Mullins, Mustafa Shakur, and Cecil Brown. Squeaky Johnson has the right-handed dribble. Dwayne Jones shows a screen, then backs off. He'll go set one for Curtis Gerald. Squeaky back with it down the lane, flips it up and scores.
Great find, great finish. Squeaky Johnson, the smallest guy on the court, going in there in the land amongst the trees and able to finish for a big two for the Toros.
Who lead it by six, 78-72. Brown to Mullins, left baseline, drives against Dwayne Jones, dumps it off. Cecil Brown, baseline two is good, and he's fouled. Alonzo G, the guilty one here.
Yeah, Byron Mullins with a great move on the baseline. You see him dribble driving, the great find. Cecil Brown was waiting Alonzo G showed great hustle getting out there trying to contest the shot. Was a little bit out of control. Ran into Cecil Brown. Now he's going to the foul line to see if he can finish up the three-point play.
78-74, now 78-75. Cecil Brown has been very impressive, the 6'4" guard out of UC Santa Barbara.
Definitely. He's doing it on both ends of the floor. Last night, you know, he played great defense when his team was down 20 points, kept trying, kept pushing, and tonight he's doing it on the defensive and the offensive end.
Curtis Gerald's just split two defenders but was called for palming.
Yeah, tough call for Curtis Gerald. 66ers doing a great job on the defensive end, the pick and roll, which killed them last night, especially in the fourth quarter. But one of the adjustments the 66ers are making are they're making Curtis Gerald give it up a little bit more. He forced it there and got the turnover.
Three-point game. Shakur gets by Jones, scores, and he's fouled against Dwayne.
That's a great move. Mustafa Shakur, not really known as a shooter, made a couple shots tonight, so the defense has to respect that, and they come out a little tighter on him. As you see here, he's able, once they come out tight on him, he's able to use his speed and quickness, get by him, and his athleticism to finish over the taller Dwayne Jones.
22 points for Shakur, and he misses the free throw. That means the Toros will retain a one-point lead. 78-77, with 7:45 left to play in the fourth. Squeaky retreats on the dribble. Checked by Cecil Brown. Veers to the right wing to Curtis Gerald. Down the lane. Beautiful pass. And Jones lays it in and one.
That's great movement. Great execution on offense. Squeaky Johnson drove, sucked the defense in from the weak side. Found Curtis Gerald at the top of the key, who had the presence of mind to drive down the middle here on the replay. Again, great hands by Dwayne Jones on the pass. He was able to catch. Had the presence of mind to use the rim as a shield for the easy lay-in and the foul.
And the free throw. Jones having a nice night. He's up to now 18 points. 81-77. Toros by four. 66ers with the ball. Clark. And it goes to Mullins. Jump hook in the lane. Way off. And knocked out of bounds. Touch last by the Toros.
Toro switched to a 2-3 zone here in the fourth quarter, trying to confuse the Tulsa 66ers. Results in a missed shot by Byron Mullins, fortunate to get the ball back off the out of bounds on the Toros.
And we do have a timeout on the floor. It is a full timeout. And we'll step aside. 81-77, Toros lead it by 4, 7:18 left to go. D-League basketball continues in a moment. Oklahoma City.
That's what you want to see if you're a 66er fan. A 19-year-old fighting and scrapping for a win, getting on the floor, getting dirty. It's good basketball.
81-79, Toros by two. Inbounds. It goes to Squeaky Johnson. Shoots the three. No good. That's a shot clock violation. Toros needed to get a quick shot at the end of that shot clock.
Yeah, it was 2 o'clock. Squeaky Johnson got caught in a bad position. Did a good job trying to get the shot off. Just unfortunate it didn't hit anything.
You think they were trying to dump it down low and just couldn't get it to one of the big guys underneath?
Possibly.
Didn't happen, though. Mullins throws the high-low pass to Brown in the lane, and a turnaround shot for Cecil Brown, who's up to 19 points.
19 points off the bench. I like this kid. He played hard. 19 points off the bench in the second night of a back-to-back.
Still has a lot of energy. Fresh legs out there.
Exactly.
Squeaky. Changing hands on the dribble, tries to penetrate, dribbles to the foul line. Now to the right baseline, shot clock at five. Beautiful pass for Jones, who gets hammered going up.
That was a great job by Squeaky Johnson. Didn't really look to have anything after, you know, the shot clock running down, but he was able to draw over Byron Mullins, freeing up Dwayne Jones in the paint. Found him, good pass. Dwayne Jones goes back to the charity stripe for two.
Squeaky Johnson goes to the bench. Lewis Clinch back in, who's been Mr. Clutch tonight with 19 points to pace the Toros. Dwayne Jones next with 18 points. Now 19 as he makes this free throw.
Lewis Clinch trying to help clinch the victory.
We're going to try to work that name in there as many times as possible down the stretch.
I think we can do it.
Toros by a point after that made free throw. Dwayne Jones to shoot one more. And the Toros lead it by 2, 83-81. The big man now with 20. For the Toros. Mustafa Shakur dribbles to his right, back to his left, stops, kicks it out, On the drive, it's Jones, dumps it down low in traffic to Clark. Great pass to the cutting Mullins, who has another easy two.
Looked like the 66ers took a page out of the Toros offensive playbook with some great interior passing.
Mullins, 14 points, 8 rebounds. Jumper, no good for Gerald's, and the rebound taken by the 66ers. It's Larry Owens. He'll try to do it himself underneath the basket. Head fake goes up, taken out of his hands by Dwayne Jones. Nice defensive play, and then Jones nearly threw it away.
Great defensive play by Dwayne Jones. That's the one thing that you want to teach your big guys. When they're going for block shots, don't come down when the offensive player is jumping up. He just stood straight up, and the offensive player, Larry Owens, brought the ball right to his hands. All he had to do was just grab it and take it away.
Curtis Gerald's moves it across the timeline. Game tied at 83. We're inside 5 minutes to play in the fourth. Which team will execute down the stretch? Dwayne Jones at the right elbow. Six to shoot. Drives against Mullins. Knocked out of his hands. Goes up. Blocked by Mullins. And Dwayne Jones touched it last. That's what I think you've been waiting to see out of Mullins. Playing some tough defense there against Dwayne Jones.
That was very good. Dwayne Jones is a smart play. Trying to drive on Mullins. Get his sixth foul. But hats off to Byron Mullins. Stood his ground, got the block shot, and actually knocked it off of Dwayne Jones out of bounds.
Brown goes to Mullins against Dwayne Jones. Double comes from Bowen. Turn shoots, blocked by Dwayne Jones. Back-to-back, beautiful defensive plays by Dwayne Jones. Clinch in the offensive end of the floor for the Toros. Lewis Clinch waiting for a screen, picks up his dribble, gives it up, gets it right back. Clinch steps back, shoots a long two, no good. And the rebound chased down by Shakur. Mustafa Shakur runs it up for Tulsa. At the 4 minute mark, passes right. Now up top, Owens bluffs the three, gives to Clark. He's open for three, too strong, high rebound. And Alonzo G out leaping Larry Owens. What a vertical he has.
Definitely, we've seen it a lot on the offensive end, but that was one of the few times we saw it on the defensive end.
Justin Bowen runs the floor and gets an easy two.
Great and finish.
Yeah, the assist from Lewis Clinch and a timeout taken by the Tulsa 66.